Hi parents, are you trying to figure out how this digital learning is working for your kids and how you can better support them? Well, one platform that teachers are using is Google Classroom. My name is Jami, Friedrich, and I'm going to walk you through how you can better support your student on Google Classroom. Thank you to Ms. Redfoot and her student Lila for helping us work through their classroom so we can see what it might look like for you. The first thing you're going to do is open up a browser. I highly recommend using Google Chrome, but if you just have Safari on your phone or your computer or Firefox or any other browser, those will work just fine. First thing you're going to do is type up here in the search engine, classroom.google.com. When you do this, if your student is not already logged in, it will prompt you to log them in here. So I'm going to type in Lila's information here. Your student will have their first initial of the first name, last initial of the last name, their student number at students with an S, hd.hcde.org. Next, most of your students' passwords should be their birthday. And if it is not, you might want to ask your student what they changed it to. Gonna sign in. Now you'll have the home page of the Google Classroom. If your student was logged in previously, it will automatically go here. You're gonna select on your student's class. We're looking at Miss Redfoot's class. So I'm gonna just click right on there. Now I should see everything that is going on. Couple different things they're going to have. The first thing you have is a stream. Think of this as a Facebook stream where every time Miss Redfoot posts, it's going to pop up right here for me. Here she had a note that said that she was arranging a Google Meet for her students. This is the type of things that you're going to be looking for in case your teacher is meeting with your students all at one time. Check in, give them instructions, whatever that might be. As your students get a little bit older, they might have more comments from other students or from the teacher as well. So sometimes this can be overwhelming. I'm going to look right here for things that Miss Redfoot, oftentimes if they have a picture next to it, it's going to be a note versus just an assignment. If I don't see any of that, I'm going to go right here to Classwork. This is where I can view all the work that my student has. You can click directly on view your work. You can see what's assigned, what's returned with a grade, and what's missing. So coming up for Lila is this quiz for the snake that's eating Florida. There's two ways to do it. I'm going to click on the interactive first. Excuse me. And I don't see anything. So what that tells me is I need to view details. Now I can do the interactive and go to a Google form. Let's see what this looks like. On this Google form, what is gonna pop up is it's a Storyworks. It has all of the instructions from the teacher. I'm gonna make sure that I'm logged in as Lila. If you have other kids or your email logs in here, you're gonna wanna switch your account if it's Lila working. And what you notice is that the quiz is right here. She's going to select the best answers that she can and submit. If this is not the way your student works, what Miss Redfoot did is if I want to go back to your work, I just press the back button and she has a printable version as well. Again, it looks like nothing is attached, but it is if you press view details. So she has the printable version here and she can add her own link or mark it as complete. If Lila has any questions, she's going to say here, Miss Redfoot, can you please help me on blah, 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 whatever that might be. If you're stuck here, you can always go back to the home page by clicking on the top. My discard changes. Classwork, again, is where everything is posted. There's links embedded here, copy and paste instructions. Again, if I click on something, I can see the instructions. But if I don't, I'm going to click view assignment. I can also go back and click View Your Work. Again, if I don't see instructions, I'm going to press View Details. The last thing I have here, which is important, is I can go to People. Here it will show me my teachers, and I can directly click on here to email my teacher if I need extra help. This is probably going to be the quickest way to get in touch with your teachers, is simply sending them an email. My internet's moving slowly, but you can see it pops up Lila's Gmail directly to my teacher. It might say help on story works assignment, and I can write Dear Miss Redfoot and any email that I have from Lila or that Lila has if she's old enough to do, like she is in this case. I'm going to go back here to get to the home page again. I'm going to press block one, and everything is here. Again, the stream is most likely like a Facebook stream. The last thing I want to point out is here you can have my upcoming What is going on? View all. Again, takes me to my assignments. As a parent, the most important for me is to notice if I have anything missing. I go to the missing assignment and it'll list everything that my student has missed and how I, and that way I can go in and help my student make up these assignments. So here we are. Again, if you go to the top, it will take me there. Now, if I select my picture, if I select the dots next to my picture, I'm going to click on Classroom, and this will take me to all of my students' classes. So if I have an elementary, middle, or high school student that has multiple classes, they will show up here, and you'll see what is due for each of those assignments. So I'm going to work with Lila, making sure she gets her work done that's due tomorrow. Here I have stuff due today, due Tuesday. You can help your student talk about what is how to prioritize their work to make sure they get it all done on time. Again, you just click right here to open up your work and you will see it all. So, good luck, parents. Y'all can do this. You can support your students. Your students should know how to work on this. If they don't, now you can show them how. And of course, anytime you have any questions, go to People and just email your teacher. Good luck, parents. You got this.